for a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, we've had a very distinguished group of your citizens from Ahoskie and other places on the train. Now they're leaving now. We want to give you their names. Could we have your attention? Could we have your attention, please? I want to introduce this group of distinguished visitors that got on with us at Norfolk. I'm Luther Hodges, Democrat from North Carolina. Mr. and Mrs. C.D. Langston, Mr. and Mrs. Langston, Mr. Allen, Mrs. Allen Powell, Mrs. Russell Martin, Mr. Joseph Bryant, Mrs. Robert Jernigan, Mr. W.H. Harrell, Mr. W.I. Johnson, Mrs. P.B. Woodley, Mr. L.E. Mazzell, Mrs. Richard Van, Mrs. J. William Copeland, Mrs. George Kittrell, Mrs. Roundtree, Mrs. John Jenkins, Mrs. Underwood, Mrs. Merrill Evans, Mr. and Mrs. T.C. Joyner, and Mrs. Lucille Beasley. Could we have quiet a minute, please? I want to present now a distinguished member of Congress from Louisiana, the Honorable Hale Boggs, to make an introduction. Hale Boggs.
Thank you very much, Secretary Hodges, ladies and gentlemen, this is a magnificent Democratic gathering, and it foreshadows the fact that President Johnson will carry the South this time stronger than any Democrat since 1944. I have heard that the candidacy of Senator Goldwater is based on what he calls the Southern strategy. Well, let me say to you that as this train moves through the South, having aboard the First Lady of the land, this train, the Lady Bird Special, Mrs. Johnson, who is as Southern as anybody can get, and the President of the United States, the first Southerner since the war between the states, we in the South, from Virginia to Texas, are not thinking about not re-electing him on November 3rd. Now, I have a pleasant task here today to introduce to you someone whom you have known for many years. You know him as your friend, as your congressman, as a man who has worked for you and for the great state of North Carolina, for eastern North Carolina, for the tobacco people, the peanut people, the cotton people, the maritime industry of North Carolina, more than any man in the history of this state and this country. It's my honor to present to you the congressman from this district, my friend, with whom I serve in the House of Representatives, the Honorable Herbert Bonham.
My friends, I'm honored and proud here today to be on the train that's bringing the First Lady of the land into North Carolina. I'm proud of the great turnout of democracy that is here today. And I'm proud of the many honors that you have paid me throughout the year. It is grand and thrilling to see so many North Carolinians here today who will support the Democratic ticket from Lyndon Johnson to on down the line and to build up the greatest Democratic majority we've ever had in North Carolina. I have the honor first to present my dear wife, Mrs. Bonner. I have the next honor to present a most beautiful lady of North Carolina, the wife of our next governor, Mrs. Dan Moore.
This is a thrilling and wonderful experience, and we are so delighted to see all of these wonderful Tar Heels here to greet the First Lady of the United States. We love all of you.
And now it is my happy privilege to present one of the belles of North Carolina, Mrs. Dan Moore, Jr. And I have the honor now and a great pleasure to present the mayor of Ahoskie, Mr. Charles Pierce.
As mayor of Ahoskie, it is my pleasure to welcome the wife of the President of the United States, Ms. Lyndon B. Johnson, and her daughter, Linda. It is also my pleasure to welcome the distinguished guests that are accompanying her here today. Thank you all for coming.
Now, if the band will kindly withhold their music, it is a distinct pleasure to have on this train the junior senator from North Carolina, Everett Jordan, who is making a great place for North Carolina in the United States Senate.
Thank you very much, Herbert. Hello to all of you. I'll be back to see you soon. Vote the Democratic ticket straight all the way down, bottom to top, top to bottom.
Ladies and gentlemen and my friends and fellow North Carolinians, back through the years, the great state of North Carolina has given its people the most wonderful government than any state in the Union, and as good as any state in the Union. We have had great governors. I have the honor today to present to you one who one who you love, and one who has worked 4 long years for the prosperity of North Carolina, for the forward march of North Carolina. He's worked for the farmer. He's worked for the tobacco farmer, the peanut farmer, and every farm of the agricultural program. He's been a great governor, and we'll miss him when the year turns. I have the honor now to present one of North Carolina's great governors, a distinguished senator, the Honorable Terry Sanford.
We couldn't have picked a better place to start off the North Carolina Lady Bird special than Ahoskie. And we do welcome Mrs. Johnson, and she has for us a message of goodwill, a message of great hope, and a message that I know will mean so much to all of America. But before she delivers that message, I want us to give her a message. I want you to let her know how we are going to support President Johnson in November. And now it is my pleasure to welcome to North Carolina and to present to you the First Lady of the land, Lady Bird Johnson.
Governor and Mrs. Sanford, Mrs. Dan Moore, Senator and Mrs. Jordan, Congressman and Ms. Bonner, and all you friends out there, I just can't tell you How happy this makes me and how wonderful it is to be greeted by such a big crowd. I know we have kept you waiting, and I'm sorry, but we kept you waiting for a mighty good reason. We found so many people back up the railroad tracks that we wanted to greet, and the crowds everywhere, all through Virginia. This delightful day has been wonderful. I understand Ahoskie began as a railroad town, and I was advised the best thing I could do was to bring along a train load of passengers. Well, I've done my best. I'm sorry we can't stay long enough to visit nearby Tawan College. I see they've come to visit us. Good. And East Carolina College. Some of my closest relatives are students, and they tell me, Mother, if you really want to make a hit, visit all the schools at class time. We tried to today, but we got behind on the schedule. No one who knows anything about North Carolina, no one who has met its great boosters, like Secretary Luther Hodges, Governor Terry Sanford, and Congressman Herbert Bonner, can fail to appreciate the fact that long ago, North Carolina put education as its number one goal. When I look at the roster of colleges there are in this state, I remember a Texas governor, never known for his willingness to budget money for the state universities, who once warned his legislature, you've gone hog wild about education. Well, I'm glad Carolina has gone hog wild about education. You have been a beacon light to the rest of the South. And there isn't a mother or father here who doesn't hope that her children will be able to prepare themselves in high schools and colleges for a prosperous future. Every child is entitled to an education. Between 1960 and 1963, the North Carolina average per capita income has increased $245, which is $13 above the national average. And I would be remiss if I didn't mind you that those have been Democratic years. I have enjoyed so much meeting and riding through the state with your many able public officials. We have come here today not just because we enjoy an autumn train ride across this Southland, but because we believe that North Carolinians are interested in good government, far-sighted government, and we believe that the party with the most heart, the most vision, the most stability is the Democratic Party. All of us are here to say what I suspect you have already guessed, that we hope you will place your confidence in the president again, in Dan Moore, in Bob Scott, in Herbert Bonner, and right on down the line. Thank you, every one of you. And I want you to know our daughter, Linda Bird.
I want to thank all these young people for coming today because I feel that I represent you and you represent me. I understand I was preceded by Buffalo Bill by a few years. But seriously, I hope that I can enlist all your aid. My generation is the volunteer generation, and we need you to volunteer to help us now. Thank you.
Ms. Johnson, on behalf of Ahoskie and the Roanoke Chowan section and the First District, we wish to present you the Yellow Rose of Texas.
Mayor Pierce, thank you. They're beautiful. They'll remind me of what's been a most wonderful start and a beginning into your great state.
They got a special sign on an overpass right down here. They want you to look.
May I thank all of you wonderful people for making North Carolina, as usual, the first and the biggest crowds we've had, and we're all so happy. And we thank your bands for coming. You can start playing because we must be going. Thank you a million.
And I want to thank everybody for coming out and welcoming the First Lady of the land.
I want to present to you two of your, a native from Roxabelle, Mr. Jack Powell, who used to pitch on the Carolina baseball team, and his wife, the White House physician, Dr. Janet Travell.
Fever, how you doing? Ahoskie has beat them all.
All right, thank you much.
Thank y'all for coming.
They're right here. They're right here.